as pastors and leaders and believers that care about your city, that care about our nation being reached for Christ, I want to thank you for partnering with us. And you know, I believe that the only way to reach our cities for Christ and reach our nation for Christ, it has to start with prayer. It has to be sustained and fueled by prayer, and it has to finish with prayer. I love this story in Genesis 18, and God says, I'm gonna go tell my buddy Abraham, my friend, that I have to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah because their wickedness has reached heaven and justice demands punishment. I don't want to, I've been long-suffering, but now justice demands it. And so he goes and shares with Abraham that he has to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah. And Abraham begins pleading with God for the destiny of a city. And I love this because God shared it with him to see what Abraham's response would be. And Abraham said, Father, would you destroy it? You know, but what if there were 50 righteous? And God said, you know what, Abraham? If there's 50 righteous, we won't destroy the city. And Abraham says, you know, Lord, forgive me. I've been to Sodom. I don't think there's 50. But what if there's 45 righteous? Would you spare the city? And God said, Abraham, for the sake of 45, I would spare the city. I'll punish the wicked, but I would spare the city for 45. And Abraham says, Lord, forgive me. What about 40? What about 30? What about 20? What about 10? And God says, all right, if there's 10 righteous found in the city, I won't destroy the city. So what does that show you? That God loves cities. That God's last resort is always judgment of a city. God loves cities. The Bible says that Abraham was looking for a city whose builder and maker was God. John the Beloved had a vision of heaven coming to earth. And what was it? It was a city called New Jerusalem. God loves cities, and God wants to see cities saved and transformed. The Bible says, can a nation be saved in a day? Yes, it can. Can it be born in a day? Yes, it can. There's no limit to what Christ can do through his church as we get his burden. And see, prayer is not just a conversation with God. Prayer is impartation from God's heart to your heart. When you really pray, when you really intercede, you begin to get God's heart, and God's heart is always for the lost. God always leaves the 99 doing well. He always goes looking out for the one lost sheep. God's heart could not be any clearer. Luke 19:10, I came to seek and save those who are lost. And so prayer is getting God's heart for your city. So the more you pray, the more you're going to want to share faith, because God loves the broken, the hurting, the poor, the lost, the hungry, the isolated, the rejected. That's God's heart. So we want to partner with God to save our cities, to save our nation. That begins with prayer. So I want to encourage you to pray, and we can pray on three different levels. Number one, as individuals, let's pray for 3, 4, 5, 10 people that we know, neighbors, family members, friends that are far from Christ. And you know, I really believe that we got to talk to Jesus about our friends before we talk to our friends about Jesus. So because prayer softens the heart. So number one, we want to see every home and every family in America adopted in prayer through All America. You can go to your app store, download the All America app, or go to allamerica.org. And let's get every home in America adopted in prayer. Number two, we want to see every city, every community, every state adopted in 24/7 prayer until Jesus comes. And as the President of America prays, we have resources for you. If you want to be part of that, you could sign up your church, your ministry for a monthly day of prayer. You can pick the first day of the month or the second Friday, and you can pray for a full day or a half a day or a quarter of a day. But you can go to AmericaPrays.org and sign up your church or your ministry, or as an individual or as a family, to be a part of this movement of day and night prayer, to see every community covered in canopies of strategic united prayer. There'll be Baptists and Catholics and Pentecostals and Calvary Chapel and Bible and everyone in between praying on the same day, praying for the same things, that God would hear from heaven and forgive our sin and save our nation and pour out his Spirit upon the nation of America and upon your community. And number three, we want to see believers gather in cities and in states all across our nation. We want to see more public prayer meetings, gatherings, prayer rallies at state capitals, at convention centers, in parks, in churches, in schools. We want to see the body of Christ come together. The Bible says, where two or three gather in my name, I am there present. If two or three agree in anything concerning my will on earth, it will be done. In John 17:21, Father, make them one. Why? So the world will believe that God sent his one and only Son. And so as we unify together as a body of Christ in prayer, what happens is it gives us power to share the one pure gospel, one Jesus, one Spirit, one Father, one Lord, one baptism with one broken world. And we believe that a unified church is the most credible witness to the world that Jesus is Lord. So I want to encourage you to, number one, pray, get every family, every home in America adopted in prayer through All America. Number two, to see every city and state in America adopted in prayer, every church, every ministry adopt a monthly day of prayer through americapraise.org. And number three, let's partner together to see the greatest movement of prayer, public prayer and proclamation of the gospel that our nation's ever seen. Go to allamerica.org for more information.